Part of this chapter comparing quantities. I hope all of you are taking good care of yourself as winters have approached in full swing. And just be careful, remain indoors and keep yourself covered. Take hot soup and be happy. Okay, let's take the second part of this chapter comparing quantities. In this chapter, we will study percentage, we'll study then fractions to percentage. We'll then do percentage to fraction. So basically we'll convert fraction to percentage, percentage to fraction, then we'll take decimal to percentage, and then towards the end we'll do the important part of application of percentage to profit loss and simple interest. So let's get started, students. So first, percentage. Percentage means 100. Cent means 100. So anything upon 100, you denote this by upon 100 or by 100. So anything upon 100 or by 100 is percentage, and cent is 100. So suppose we take 5%, it is 5 upon 100. 2% is 2 upon 100. So anything upon 100 is percentage, right? Now fraction to percentage. We get a number, any fraction we get, and we want to convert to percentage. What we do? We simply multiply by 100. Suppose A upon B is a fraction and B is not equal to 0. See, denominator cannot be 0, otherwise it is undefined. So fraction will be any number A upon B and B not equal to 0. Now let's take an example, 7 upon 10 and another example, 1 upon 4. These are two fractions. We want to convert to percentage. So what we do, 7 upon 10 into 100, multiply by 100, which is 700 upon 10, which is 70%. 1 upon 4 into 100, which is 100 upon 4, which is 25%. So this is the simple logic. Whenever you want to convert fraction to percentage, multiply by 100. Now vice versa, if you get a percentage and you want to convert to fraction, then we divide by 100. Divide means into 1 by 100. So let's take an example. We divide by 100 or 1 upon 100. So 70%, 25%, 5% and 2%. These are all percentage. We want to convert to fraction. So 70% will be 70 into 1 by 100, which is 70 by 100, which is 7 by 10. 25%, 25 into 1 by 100, which is 1 by 4. 5%, 5 into 1 by 100, which is 5 by 100, which is 1 by 4. 1 by 20, sorry, 1 by 20. And 2 into 1 by 100 is 2 upon 100, which is 1 by 50. So 1 by 50, 1 by 20, 1 by 4, 7 by 10 are all fractions. Now last part here, decimal to fraction. We have a decimal number 5.6. We have another decimal number 2.3. These are all decimal numbers. We want to convert to percentage. So again we multiply by 100. So remember, if there is a percentage and want to convert to fraction, if there is a fraction and you want to convert to percentage, then multiply by 100. Fraction to percentage, multiply by 100. Same way, if there is a decimal and you want to convert to fraction, then you again multiply by 100. But the difference is in the point. So let's say 5.6 decimal number into 100 is percentage. So 5.6 into 100 is 5600. And then how do we put decimal point? Decimal point, we'll just see how many digits are to the right of the decimal point. There is one digit. So when we put the decimal point, we will see from right to left and the number of digits. So number of digits was 1. So from right to left, we will put decimal point after one digit. So from right to left after one digit, so it will be 560. It will be 560, which is 560%. So what we have done, decimal to percentage, we just multiplied by 100 and we checked how many digits are there to the right of the decimal point. There is one digit. So when we have to put the decimal, we have to take from right to left and count the number of digits. Number of digits was 1, and from right to left after one digit you put decimal point. So it is 5600 after one digit, from right to left 560, and you put the percentage, right? So this is the same thing here also. 2.3 into 100, multiply by 100, which is 2300, and in the same, with the same logic, we will put 230%, right? Now put decimal after one place, right to left. This is what I already explained to you. Okay. Now important point. I'll tell about cost price, selling price, profit, percentage, loss percentage, and we will discuss about simple interest. Okay, so little bit of theory here. What is the cost price? Whenever you purchase some article, it is at the cost price, and when you sell the article, it is at a selling price. So selling price is when you sell. So usually selling price is always higher than the cost price. Why it is so? It is so because we all want to sell something at profit. We never want to sell at loss. But when it comes to questions, you can also get a question on loss. So the only difference is that whenever there is a profit, see here. Let's take an example. Cost price is purchase price, selling price is selling price, right? So if selling price is 120, cost price is 100, what is the profit? SP minus CP. Profit is SP minus CP. So, which means SP is greater than CP. SP is greater than CP. But if SP is less than CP, which means SP is 100 and CP is 120, let's take that way, then it will be loss, because you are selling at a lower price. You are selling at 100, but the cost price is 120, so 20 rupees of loss. Now, the important thing to remember, profit is SP minus CP, right? And what is loss? CP minus SP. So one thing just remember, in both the cases, loss or profit, it is always minus sign. It is always minus sign. Now you have to decide how to put minus sign. CP minus SP in loss and SP minus CP in profit. So the only thing is that just remember the simple logic. Whenever there is a difference, you always put the difference or subtract by a higher number with a lower number in most cases. So always remember, if it is a loss, you will put a higher number only first. The higher number is CP here. So the higher number is CP here. So whenever you put a loss on a profit, higher number has to be put first. So what happened when you get a question of loss? You will see cost price is always higher than the selling price. Cost price will be always higher than the selling price. So you will have to put cost price first. So I'm just giving you a trick. Cost price first, cost price minus SP. And if it is a profit, then you normally know. If it's a profit, it is always selling price which is higher. But whatever be the question given to you, you just see which is the higher number. If the higher number is there, if it is a loss given, and the number is, one number is higher, the higher number is the cost price if it's a loss. But the higher number in the case of profit will be selling price. So this is what I am trying to explain. But anyway, if you can even remember, so loss is CP minus SP and profit is SP minus CP. Then what is profit percent? So same thing upon CP into 100. So profit percent or loss percent, whenever you talk about percent, it is upon 100. So profit upon CP into 100. Into 100 here means into 1 into 100. So profit, first of all, profit. Profit upon CP. So profit percent is always on the CP. Loss percent is always on the CP. Both are on the CP, nothing on the SP. When you talk about profit percent, you will just put denominator as CP in both the cases. So profit upon CP into 100, always on CP. Loss percent, loss upon CP into 100. Again, CP will be in the denominator. So simple, what is loss? CP minus SP. What is profit? SP minus CP. Now, another question here arises, gain percent and loss percent. So profit is also said to be gain percent. Loss percent is also said to be loss percent on loss. Loss percent you know, but gain percent and profit. Profit and gain is same, right? So profit, it can you can get gain percent or you can get profit percent, same thing, right? Which means SP is higher than the CP. Got it? Now there is another situation wherein SP is equal to CP 1 plus gain percent. This one formula. Now what, when this arises, for sometimes you are given a gain percent and you are given SP is given, CP is not given. Now there is a formula. Remember again, CP is not given, SP is given, and a gain percent is given. There can also be a possibility when loss percent is given, SP is given, but again CP is not given. So in this case, the formula is SP is equal to CP 1 plus gain percent. SP is equal to CP 1 plus gain percent. But if a loss is given, then same thing, SP is equal to CP 1 minus loss percent. Because, so 1 minus 1, what is loss percent? Suppose, now take an example. If the loss, if the, let's take first the gain. If the gain or profit is 20%, then SP is equal to CP 1 plus 20%. 1 plus 20% write as 1 plus 20 by 100 is equal to 120 by 100. So CP into 120 by 100 is equal to SP. Why SP in the left hand side? Because SP is given. SP is equal to CP 1 plus 20 by 100, or you can say SP is equal to CP into 120 by 100. And then you can always calculate the CP. Because everything is given, you just transpose, you know, right? And what about the loss? Suppose again, same example, now loss is 20%. Loss is 20%. What this means? This means same formula. SP is equal to CP 1 minus loss percent, which is 1 minus 20 by 100. 1 minus 20 by 100 is 80 by 100. So you will do CP into 80 by 100. SP is equal to CP into 80 by 100 if the loss is 20%. And SP is equal to CP into 120 by 100 if it is a gain of 20%. So whatever be the situation, loss or gain given to you, you just see, suppose again another example I give it to you, 8%. If the gain is 8%, it is 1 plus 8 by 100, which is 108 by 100 into CP is equal to SP. Situation is same. SP is given to us. Gain of 8% is given to us. CP is not given. Formula is same. SP is equal to CP 1 plus gain percent. Right? Which means 1 plus 8 by 100, which is 108 by 100. So what happens? 108 by 100 will become ultimately 27 by 25. You will cut it and it will. I also give you one example for this. And CP will be, and SP in case of, and CP in case of loss percent, SP is equal to CP 1 minus loss percent, which I already explained to you, 1 minus 20 by 100, which is 80 by 100. Okay? So, we'll have a question on this as well. Now, we come to the concept of interest. Right? So, you go to a bank, what actually happens in a bank? There are two scenarios. If you have money, you will deposit the money in your bank. Right? You deposit the money in your bank, like you deposit in your, suppose there's a piggy bank you have, you deposit the money and you take it after 1 year. So, you have to keep on putting money to get a good amount of money. But what happens in a bank? You will just go, either do a fixed deposit. Let's not take this word fixed deposit here. Let's take an example. You go with 1,000 rupees and give it to your bank. It's your money. It's not bank's money. You give 1,000 rupees to a bank and tell the bank that I will take this money after 1 year. So bank will give you interest. Bank will give you interest. So bank will actually give you the amount, which is 1,000 rupees, plus the interest which you earn on 1,000 rupees. So you will get 1,100 rupees, right? So because say suppose 10% is the interest. So what happens? That is one scenario. But if you borrow money from the bank, borrow, because bank is the lender. If you borrow the money from the bank, then what happens? The bank has to be paid. You will have to pay the bank the interest. This is the only difference. See, so the formula is simple interest is equal to P into R into T upon 100, where P is the principal, which is the money borrowed. Usually we borrow the money from the bank, right? Or bank gives you loan. So principal is 1,000, rate is 10%, and time is 2 years, right? Suppose in 2 years, after 2 years, you will have to pay the interest to the bank. So what is the interest? Simple interest. Now let's see how. 1,000 into 10. R percent is 10%, so it is basically 10 by 100. So it is basically principal into rate percent, which is principal is 1000 into 10 by 100 into 2. Because time period is 2. If you calculate this, it is 200 rupees. So what happens after 2 years? You will go to the bank and you have to pay the bank 1000 plus, which is the principal also you have to pay to the bank, plus the interest, which is 200 rupees. So you will have to pay bank 1200 rupees after 2 years. But what happened? The bank gave you the money and you can utilize it from today only. But you will have to pay the bank after 2 years, which is 1200, which is the amount. Amount is principal plus interest. So you have to pay back the money to the bank after 2 years, which is principal plus interest. That's called the amount, right? But if the bank says, usually bank will not say, it's the amount which you pay back to the bank, because it was for say 2 years. So this is what is mentioned here. If borrowed from bank, you pay interest. If borrowed from bank, you pay interest. If you deposit, you get interest. Simple. Okay. Now let's do some questions. I hope this is clear to you. So if TV purchased at ₹7,500 and sold at 6,600, find profit or loss percent. Isn't it a simple question? Yes, it is. You just have to be very cool-headed when you solve these questions. Simply, purchase price is CP, which is 7,500. So selling price is 6,600. Now, the very first thing, it's asking you whether it's profit or loss. Let's see how. When we see that the selling price is less than the cost price, selling price is less than the cost price, right? So it is a loss. It is a loss. So it's a loss. First of all, loss. And then also loss percent. So find profit or loss. What is this? CP is 7,500. SP is 6,600. So CP is greater than SP. CP is greater than SP, right? So it is a loss. And how much is the loss? Loss upon CP into 100. Again, as I told you in the concept, whenever you have to take loss percent or profit percent, it is always on the CP. First you put the loss, which is CP minus SP. Again you see, loss is CP minus SP. Loss upon CP, always CP into 100. CP minus SP is loss upon CP into 100. Denominator just put CP every time. If it's a loss, it is CP minus SP. If it is a profit, it is SP minus CP. This is the case of loss. CP 7500 minus 6600 SP upon 7500 into 100. Why? Because CP has to be put whenever it's a loss or a profit percent. First we did determine that it is a loss because the CP was higher than the SP. So it is 900 upon 7500 into 100. So this becomes 2 zeros you cut. Sorry, 2 zeros you cut here and 2 zeros here. So it is 900 upon 75. So if you take this by 3, this is 25 by 300 by 25. And then this eventually becomes, if you do it by 5, 5 times 25, 560 is 300, and then it is 12%. So 12% is what? Profit or loss? Loss, right? Okay. So herein, you don't have to, you don't have to get confused. It will always be SP minus CP or CP minus SP. And if it's a loss, CP is higher, right? Because usually in difference also, you see the first digit has to be higher. So if it's a loss scenario, CP will be there because CP will be higher. So always put the higher number first. This is one trick. You have to understand that, right? So in difference, usually it is 5 minus 4. It is not 4 minus 5 in most cases. So here in what I'm saying that when it's a loss, CP is always higher. So the higher number has to be kept first always. If it's a profit, again the higher number is SP here. Higher number has to be put first because in loss or profit, it is always SP minus CP. And again, CP minus SP, right? So minus has to be there in both the cases. So let's proceed now. Now, the question is, by selling an electric iron, which means selling price is given. By selling an electric iron for ₹540. The question is, it's already mentioned ₹540 is the selling price. A shopkeeper gains 8%. Find the CP. Same thing which I already, this second part of this concept. Here an SP is given to you, 540. CP is not given and gain is given. Simple formula, SP is equal to CP 1 plus gain percent. Now, let's put it over here. CP is equal to question mark, not given to you. SP 540, gain 8%. Simply apply the formula, SP is equal to CP 1 plus gain percent, which means SP is equal to 540 is equal to CP 1 plus 8 by 100, right? 1 plus 8 by 100 is 108 by 100. So it is CP into 108 by 100, right? Which means CP into, if you do by 2, it will be 54 upon 50, and then it will be 27 upon 25, right? So ultimately, you will simplify this and it will be CP into 27 by 25, which means 540 is equal to CP into 27 upon 25. Now just transpose the things. You want to get the CP. CP, if you put CP here, then this will go here. 25 will go here on the left hand side. So 540 into 25 and 27 will go come down. Divide by 27. This is how you do the things when you shift the denominator to the right hand side. And if there is an equal sign, so this will become into 25 and this will be divided by 27. So this is 27 into 54, and there is 0 also 20. 20 into 25 is 500. So CP is 500. Now you can even cross check this. gain of 8%. Find the CP. So selling price is 540 and CP has to be less than, because there is a gain percent. So CP has to be less, because 540 is the selling price and CP is 500, which normally or logically is very good. This is correct to think that way, because cost price will be less because it is already gain given to you. I hope you got this. Okay. So I proceed now. So here I took one example wherein you give the concept of amount. After 2 or 3 years, or say after 1 year, you will pay the bank, because bank is the lender. Lender means it will, you are borrowing from the bank. One who lends money. So one who lends money, who is the lender? You are not the lender, you are the borrower. So lender is the bank. Lender is the bank. So one who gives money is bank. So when the bank will give you money, you will take money, which means you have to pay him interest and the principal both. So principal plus interest is amount. Remember this. Principal plus interest is amount, which is that amount you have to give after 1 year or 2 years, whatever is given to you. Now let's see. This we already taken one example here, wherein 1000 principal was 1000, rate was 10%, time was 2 years. After 2 years, you will have to pay the bank how much? 200 rupees plus the 1000 rupees also, which was the principal amount you took from your bank, which you took from the bank, which is 1200, right? That's the amount. Now the question is, find the simple interest on 15,000 for 3 years at 5%. Find amount as well. Two parts. First part, you know, amount is principal plus interest. Remember this formula. Interest is what? P into R into T upon 100. It means principal into rate percent. Rate percent is whatever rate percent given to you, 5% is given over here, and time is 3 years here. So we put 15,000. Into rate percent is R by 100, which is 5 by 100 into 3. It is not P into R into T and upon 100 special. You don't have to put 100. That 100 is of rate percent only. So again, see, this is very important. Though a lot of students know it, but see, P into R into T upon 100 means P into rate percent, which is if 5%, then 5 by 100. Then you don't have to specially put upon 100. That is 15,000 into 5%, which means 15,000 into 5 by 100 into 3. Right? P into R into T. R is usually percent only. So R percent will be given to you, 5%. So if you do this, it is, you will just get 2 zeros here and 2 zeros here. This becomes 150 into 5 into 3, which means 150 into 15. So this becomes 15 into 15 is 225 and 10. 2250. This is 2250 is the interest, right? So after 3 years, you will have to pay back to the bank, because you took 15,000 from the bank or from any place. It is not your money. You took money from the bank to use it. So today only you can, bank will not bother. Bank will just take money from you after 3 years. After 3 years, bank will say, okay, give my 15,000 rupees and also the interest, which is 2250. So amount is what the bank will ask you to pay. So after 3 years, you will have to pay principal plus interest. This is the formula. 15,000 plus 2250, which is 17,250. That's how it goes. Okay, so this was the whole concept wherein we used this percent. We knew percentage, we knew how to convert fractions to percentage, percentage to fraction, decimal to percentage, and then we applied the principle of percentage to profit loss and simple interest. Simple interest is P into R into T upon 100, and also the amount is principal plus interest. I hope this chapter is clear, and this is the concept and some questions which were relevant, and then you can keep on practicing. But overall, this is what is all this chapter is all about. In the first part, whatever was mentioned to you, that is one aspect. So you just remember that chapter also, and herein we discuss the application of a percentage to profit loss and also to simple interest, right? So I hope this is clear to you, and you like this chapter. If you like it, can give like and just keep on watching my channel. I feel happy that you are busy and you are liking it, and you just take good care of yourself, eat well and sleep well. Take care. Bye.